was a kid. No parents, no home. Running messages and picking pockets to keep my ribs from meeting my spine. One night I saw a man. Folks just passed him by like he wasn't there. I thought he must have something valuable, so I snuck up on him and made a grab.
That's not for you.
Please, sir, I'm hungry. Don't tell the Hammers, I promise.
What is your name, boy?
Garrett.
You have talent, lad.
Let go of me, old man!
To see a keeper is not an easy thing. Especially one who does not wish to be seen. We have a need for those as gifted as yourself. If you've grown tired of how you live, then follow me, and we will show you a different way.
Leave me alone!
As you wish.
I caught up with him just before he vanished into the crowd. It was the beginning of a very long education.
In the nearby rooms, I will instruct you in the various skills you will need to survive. Please stay in the entrance area to each room while I explain the room's purpose. When you are ready to begin your lessons, proceed down this hallway to the first room. You must learn how to move unseen. Stay in the shadows. Avoid the light. The indicator on your screen will tell you how visible you are. Try to reach the top of the platform without being seen.
I see you there, lad.
Try again. Remember, stay out of the well-lit areas until you reach the platform.
Well done. I did not see you approach.
Open this door to continue. Good. Proceed down this corridor for your next test.
The keepers were training me to be one of them, but I found other uses for those skills.
I have a simple job planned for this evening. Break into a guarded mansion, steal another fat nobleman's priceless trinket, and leave quietly. Lord Bafford is out of town, and rumor has it that the captain of his house guard went with him as a bodyguard. The time is ripe for a bit of burglary. The front gate of Lord Bafford's manor is always guarded, and the main street is far too exposed. But Cuddy tells me there's a better way in, around to the side, more out of the way. One guard, and likely no witnesses to complicate matters. The piece Cuddy wants is a scepter, silver, jewels, the usual adornments. It should command a high price. Bafford, like most of his kind, probably keeps his treasures on the top floor of the place, close to his heart, and far from his servants. No point in waiting. I have Cuddy's old sketches of the place, and everyone who's going to be asleep inside already is. It's time to begin.
I'm going to the bear pits tomorrow. You want to come with?
Couldn't pay me enough.
What? You soft belly. The bears have got these new muzzles with underslung cheek spikes. Last time I was there, there was a real eye gouging.
Nah. It makes me sick. When I was a kid...
Huh. Surprised you're even in this job.
Ooh, the blood, it just turns my poor tummy.
Shut up, you taffer. You want blood? You should have been there years ago. Tell you, the bears then, they were something to see. Those bears, they didn't need no cheek spikes and razor collars and paw hooks and all that knifery you straps to them now.
No paw hooks? What'd they do? Just bump into each other?
Huh! Nah! The bears back then, they had claws as long as your finger! And wicked teeth!
Bears? You're daffing me. They look pretty mangy harmless, long as they're not wearing harness.
That's why I can't stand the pits now. You don't know what you missed. They just don't make bears like they used to.
Whoa! Killer bears! Would you like to see that?
How's it going?
Only one guard. Still, it'd be nice to get the drop on him.
If I can hit him with the blackjack without being spotted, he'll drop without a sound.
Guy needs to lose some weight.
It's a long way down. Not my most elegant entrance, but it worked. Inside at last.
And I've been thinking, the sir could really beef up security some.
What do you mean? What's wrong with us?
Well, we're fine, but I've been thinking we should watch the outsides more.
That's stupid! People to worry about there on the inside!
No, then you catch them before they get inside, you taffer.
Oh!
Clanky metal grating. I'd better tread softly.
Must be the maid's night off. Perfect. Only one. And he's looking the other way. Nighty-night.
What's there?
Someone behind me?
Since I'm in here, I might as well pick up something for myself. I wonder if he reads them or if it's just for show.
Can't stand the food here. This place.
Better not let anyone bang that gong, or I'll have more company than I can handle. Can you get? Here we go.
Thank you.
I went to Cuddy's place to deliver the scepter, but Cuddy wasn't there. He'd been arrested by the Hammerites. Apparently, they didn't approve of his occupation, and I doubt they approve of mine. So hopefully they'll never catch sight of me when I break him out of their prison. Which is what I'm going to do. They're holding Cuddy in a mining complex carved out of a quarry. The quarry's flooded, but the Hammers still work the top-level mines and have converted part of the complex into a penitentiary for those who violate their tenets. An associate of mine was confined there and has provided me with a map. It would be difficult to get in by way of the main gate, but there is another option. The mines break the surface of a hill south of the quarry. I'll drop into the mines and head for the prison, which will be found somewhere uphill and to the north. The Hammers don't venture into these lower mine levels because they're reputed to be haunted. I'd rather not have to do this job, but Cuddy's a reliable fence and I don't appreciate the Hammerites abducting him. And he owes me money for the Bafford job. I can swim better than anyone carrying a sledgehammer.
Would be close-packed with novices, striving to learn our teachings.
There are novices still.
But fewer, brother, fewer. Youths in this time seek to learn about gold and politics, not honest craft.
'Twill be their loss when they come of age and know not how to accomplish aught of consequence.
He can't see me while I stick to the shadows. But I'll have to cross into the light in order to get to the stairs.
Every act that I see performed except by myself, well, I can't do it all by myself.
All these people I have to work with, so incompetent, so stupid, so lazy. I don't see why I should be the one to be put with these incompetent people.
Just what the world needs, more Hammers.
I shouldn't leave the body lying around.
Sounds like I'm getting close.
Vigilance is our shield that protects us from the squalid past. Knowledge is our weapon with which we carve a path to an enlightened future.
I should be near the prison entrance by now.
In truth, I have never heard such carrying on as this thief's pawned cutty.
One would think these scum had never faced tribulation in their lives.
For a time, I thought Block 4 might never sleep again for his coughs. But he quiets now.
Good. Death or Dorrance, 'twill be the same for him in the end.
These guys just have no sense of humor.
Tis the builder's piece now.
Right. Cell block 4. Cuddy, you better appreciate this. Someone walks by here, they might figure out something's up. But which one is Cuddy? All right, old man. Let's get you out of here and me my money.
Afraid you're gonna be disappointed?
Good thing you're dying, Cuddy. Or I'd have to kill you for stiffing me. Again.
Snap, snap, puppy. But I owe ya. So... Felix went after the Horn of Quintus. Down the Bone Horde. Left me his notes. The Hammer's got him. Put him in their evidence box. Loot collection, more like. Stairs. Officer's quarters. Once you're up there. In passage. If damp hadn't rotted my lungs.
Well, this was a lost cause. Time to get out before I end up in the cell next door.
And the builder said, if the foundation is weak, do you wail and gnash your teeth? Do you ask it to repour itself? Nay, you tear it down and begin anew.
That shut him up.
Hand. My hammer awaits thee!
No, I see the power. I shall find thee and crush thee. Think thou shalt escape. Our foe.
Receive thy pounding!
Lend thy strong arm to mine!
Thou shalt not escape me!
Thy death is at hand! Thy sin has brought thy death! Swing, brother! written in the book. Thy sin has brought thy death. Now, feel the spike of thy sin!
No point going that way. It'll be crawling with hammers. How they spend all those tithes. Pissed at Cuddy for a good while after the prison debacle. But hey, you can't blame him for what the hammers did to him. So I decided to go after that horn Felix talked about. Not like I had a whole lot of choice, really. The rent is due. My landlord's even tougher than the hammers. I had some money to spare after disposing of the horn, so it seemed time to invest in some new tools. Farkas is one of the few merchants willing to risk selling to an independent like me, and his prices are steep. But the other choice is to let one of the so-called city wardens give me orders, and take a cut of my profits. They've been after me for years to join one of their stables, but I'm not interested. Maybe they'll get the idea and give up. More likely, they'll just ramp up the threats. Nothing I can't handle if I'm careful. And lucky. And my luck seems to have finally turned for the better. That shot was meant for me.
Yes, I'm sure it was Garrett in the window. He's dead. Let's head back now.
These creeps are gonna lead me right back to whoever sent them to kill me, but only if I can tail them without them noticing me. These are Ramirez's boys. I think it's time I dealt with Mr. Ramirez once and for all.
Jorik tells me the hammers are gonna close down Cragscleft.
Yeah, he's taffing you. Where are they gonna put the poor saps they grab?
Dunno. Toss them into a well or something. Anyhow, they just don't have enough guys no more.
Kinda sad. Used to be the power. Now they're just a bunch of guys wishing for the old days. Oh well.
Must have been oh well.
Don't know what it was.
Too many for me to take all at once.
Thank you.
here, you're going to be assigned monster babysitting.
What? Why me?
The boss thinks his nasties don't get enough affection. You'll be down there rubbing their tummies.
I'll quit first! See if I don't!
Who'd break in here? The only action we get is when somebody tries to skim off the top.
I thought Quince and Jacko were on watch tonight.
The boss sent them on a special errand. Some fellow he wants dead. A thief. Name of Garrett.
I've heard of him. Garrett. No one to be trifled with. That's what I heard.
Not anymore if he's had a visit from those two.
Peaceful, isn't it?
Enjoy it while it lasts, friend. His fatness will be back soon to make our lives miserable again.
Where is he then? I haven't seen him tonight.
Down in the cellar again, counting his loot. I hope he stays down there all night. You know, the barricades.
The closed areas. Not a chance.
Look, you!
Help,
stop lurking
help.
Back there! I won't have any servants lurking.
Good to grab loot. It may be time for me to move along now. Don't want to wear out my welcome. I was going to pay Lord Randall and his vase collection a visit, but the Downwind Thieves Guild beat me to the score. Word is that they haven't divvied the booty yet. Apparently their leaders, Donald and Reuben, are arguing over the prized sapphire vase. Sounds like they could use a third party to settle their disagreement. Since I'm no mediator, I'll just steal the vase from them. They'll be so busy blaming each other, no one will suspect an outsider. The Downwinders run a gambling den called the Overlord's Fancy, which operates under a nearby restaurant. The guild's hideout is beneath the casino. I have a rough map of the complex I got from sources from the inside. Once I'm in the Overlord's Fancy, I'll have to search for the secret entrance to the hideout. I have to be careful. The Downwinders know me all too well. If they catch sight of me, they'll know who took the vase. Assuming they don't just kill me for trespassing. Finding the vase may prove difficult since I have no idea where it is. Should be a hot topic of conversation among the downwinders. Maybe I'll be lucky enough to overhear where they're stashing it. Time to make a living.
Password.
Reeves Ballsutter, it's me.
Security is necessary to prevent exposure and dilution of talent. Do you want to argue with the lords? Now what's the password?
Hand of shadow, foot of air. Open the door, okay?
Well, now he hasn't given me the password.
Are you taffing me?
Security is necessary to prevent...
And I'm standing here listening to Dano tell you the password. You think he's gonna let me if I'm not in the guild? Or you think I'm lackwit enough not to remember it?
Sutter, I'll put up with your airs a ways, but if you start putting it like I'm that much of a fool, there will be blood. Now open this door!
Maybe I should head back to my own neighborhood. Those fellas don't seem too friendly. Back door.
I think I'd be used to rat noises by now.
Play you again?
Playing tricks on me.
Ah, you always win. But enough money.
Here, I'll let you guess first.
Like that helps me, you taffer.
Come on, low bets. Double or nothing.
Double or nothing. Stone or coin?
Coin.
Damn you! Here.
Not so secret anymore, is it?
Donal and Reuben can kill each other for all I care. While they fight over the vase, they stay out of my way.
Yeah, but while they're squabbling, they ain't fencing the vase neither. That vase is just gonna stay locked up in Lord Donal's lair.
Yeah, but it's not like it's doing Donal any good, since Lord Reuben has the key to the lockup.
Ain't doing me no good neither. That sapphire vase is worth more than the rest of the score from Randall's combined. I didn't become a downwinder to work for free. I want my cut.
That's what I needed to hear.
Bafford was furious when he got back from his trip and found out his precious scepter had been swiped.
We didn't pull that job, did we?
You taffer, if we pulled a job on one of Ramirez's people, it would be war.
Well, who then?
Probably Garrett. He's the only one sly and foolish enough to pull a job like that.
Thank you. Just keep looking the other way.
Hey.
Better not leave too many bodies lying around. Now I can get my vase. This is what I'm looking for. This'll make any fence crack a smile.
Huh? Sit right there, Garrett.
This looks like the way out. I was contacted by a woman named Victoria. She claims to represent a client who was impressed by the way I took care of Ramirez, and now wants me to steal something for him. The target is a magical sword, owned by a nobleman and collector named Constantine. Little is known about Constantine except that he is an eccentric new face in the city, and mostly keeps to himself. Victoria says the sword will probably be on display, but it will be well protected by guards and security systems. She also mentioned that the guards are tough and organized, and the mansion is confusing to navigate in. The house was constructed recently, so I've had to piece together my own map from observation and hearsay. Sounds like the place is a bit of a maze. I guess if you're rich enough, you can build any sort of madhouse to live in. This is going to be a challenging job, but it'll pay better than the last few I've taken. As usual, the front entrance is heavily guarded, but I've managed to find another way in. Of course, once I've picked up the sword, I'll still have to worry about getting back out.
What's going on over there?
Hello? Is someone there?
Nothing here now.
Magical traps. I guess he's serious about his privacy. Here.
Thank you.
that can't go anywhere pleasant. I don't like the looks of this. This is interesting. Go this way. Not this way.
What I see there, I must own nothing. I saw something. I don't see anything now.
This looks interesting.
Boss is dangerous today.
I thought he'd a good mood.
Yeah, I told you. Good moods. That's the worst.
Thank you.
time to take my new sword and get out of this crazy place. I'll just sneak out through the windows.
Garrett, it's Victoria. I trust you made it back alive. You've done well, Garrett. Come with me and bring the sword. There is someone you have to meet. It's time for the payment you've been promised.
Yes.
A refreshment, Mr. Garrett. I'm in the possession of a superior brandy that has the most restorative effect.
I prefer my payment in cash, not liquor, Mr.
My apologies. I've been watching you, Mr. Garrett, so closely, in fact, that I'm afraid I'd forgotten we haven't actually met yet. I am Constantine.
All this time I thought you were going to pay me. You've brought me here to kill me?
But you have it all wrong, Mr. Garrett. Would it surprise you to know that it was I who hired you to steal my own sword? Yes. You see, Victoria and I are...
old associates.
Yes. You were being tested, do you understand? And I must say, you more than live up to your reputation. You are quite an extraordinary thief.
Testing me? What is it you want from me, Constantine?
I am a collector, Mr. Garrett. But there are some items that are not available for purchase. They must be acquired using other means. In this case, the item in question would be best acquired by thieving. Not simple thieving. No. I need an artist like yourself.
What exactly is this item?
It is the gemstone called the Eye, for its unusual...
appearance.
Yes. Kept hidden in the sealed cathedral deep inside the halls of the scum Hammerites. Oh, but forgive me. You are, possibly, friendly with the Order of the Hammer.
No. Fanatics make unreliable friends.
Excellent. I am prepared to offer you quite a sum. 100,000 upon receipt of the Eye.
I don't see how I can refuse such an offer.
Marvelous. Victoria can fill you in on all the particulars. And Mr. Garrett... the sword. Keep it. You have earned it, but also, I believe you'll find it useful in your quest.
Constantine wants is in the abandoned cathedral of the Hammerites. The cathedral is located in a section of the city that was deserted years ago, after some kind of catastrophe. I've heard stories of the incident. Most are wild rumors about hordes of zombies and raging fires. Now that part of the city is walled off, and no one's allowed to go in. Not that many people would dare to in the first place. Maps of the area are easy to find in attics and old trunks, but like all of them, the one I've got is over 50 years old. I'll make my way through the ruins to the Hammerite Cathedral and find a way inside. Once I get inside the cathedral, I'll have to locate the Eye. Something tells me that this is not going to be easy, but for the amount I'm getting paid, I'm willing to take some serious risks.
Yeah.
this was probably a marketplace. Too crazy about the neighborhood. What's that sound? Damn, there has to be another way in.
Wow.
Not even the hammers could make heads or tails of this, but it doesn't look good. Looks like this place was built by my old pals, the Keepers. I wonder what they're hiding in here. And how am I gonna get the door open? This must have been some sort of library. This is interesting, but it doesn't say anything about the eye. Keepers have hidden the Talisman of Fire in a place they call the Lost City. Some kind of cataclysm buried the place underground ages ago. The Keepers have sealed the access to the city, a cleft in the river bottom near the east side. If the materials in the library are right, the strange stone I found can be used to open that seal. I've also got a map. It's so old, the edges crumble in my hands. It shows the city, or at least how it was back then. I hope the old place hasn't changed much. Thank you.
There must be a way down there. Another way around. Time to raid some tombs. So, this is the lost city. It's not lost no more. How can the keepers keep this place a secret?
I shall walk the path to my return. Sweet silence return.
Whoa.
Build shelters from the winds, feel the countless waters, see the vast earth,
Uh-oh.
Do not flee.
How rude.
To stir will only bring death. Feel the sting of my anger.
I wonder how I can get up there. You've got to be kidding me. It's a long way down. Good thing I'm not afraid of heights. Now for the talisman. The Talisman of Earth is guarded by a foreign mages sect known as the Hand Brotherhood. They reside in a compound of huge towers where they practice their arts of earth, air, fire, and water. The talisman is likely kept in the Earth Tower, but there's little chance it'll be that simple. No doubt the talisman is heavily guarded and probably protected by magic. But mages love to write everything down. I should stumble on something useful about their precious trinket. I bribed some servants to get me a map of the common grounds, best I could do since only the mages are allowed in the towers. I'll enter the courtyard just outside the central keep entrance. Once inside, I'll need to move quickly to find the talisman. I wouldn't last long in a fight against the mages.
These mages are not ones to be trifled with. Saw them use their magic on old Bradwart. The mages caught them stealing lupins from the tables of the meeting hall. One of them summoned great hurtling balls from the sky, glowing rocks from the moon they was, and they mashed in his poor skull.
Any intruders better hope we get to him first before the hand mages do.
Da-da-dum-da-da-dum.
Do not let fear control your path, Garrett. Deception is your power, Garrett. Betrayal will force you to see, Garrett. Greed shall be your undoing, poor Garrett.
So this is where the mages hide their dirty little secrets.
Ready. Rough waters lie ahead.
Many will not survive. We must try to redirect the current.
Try as we might to retrieve the talismans, the prophecy is an ocean returning to shore. Little we can do to prevent it and prepare for its arrival.
Dry and dead is much of the city. The sun will oppose and the conflict will end in flames.
It's the way of things. Civilizations will burn into the earth, so that it may give life to the next.
Winds of progress always head towards the grave.
Soon, young apprentice, you shall grasp the truth of it.
If I keep going up, I'm gonna run out of building. Keepers stash the talisman of water in a series of hidden caverns located deep below the city. According to their map, I'll find it in a shrine located in the lowest cavern. I don't expect to run into anything too threatening other than a few venomous spiders. However, the map does contain this note. Stand not against us, lest you feel the sting of ignorance's barbs. Sounds like Keeper talk for, we've rigged the place. An informant of mine, Geary, made a home for himself in these caverns after he lost his job tending the ticket counter of a nearby opera house. He should know these caverns better than anyone, so I'll pay him a visit to see if he has any useful information for me. Guess I'm not getting any information from Geary after all. Now what?
A big fish, rather. Are you here to sing too? We'll reenact the memorable scene between Raoul and Valerius at the bridge. I'll begin. The city at night. Raoul, the handsome young opera house owner, sings to the lady Valerius. I, Raoul, do accuse you of using treachery to obtain your wealth. Then Lady Valerius sings.
I, Lady Valerius, have obtained the opera house, yes. Right from under your nose, you must kiss the ground underneath my toes.
Now, I live here, under the opera, but I go back, stealing food and such as I need. She can't kick me out, not Raoul. Then they come down, looking for spiders, but they found the treasure from the shrine instead. Now, she has that, too. I've seen her with it. It has powers. You could steal it from her, yes. That would make her sad. Let's see. What would she sing? I know. Lady Valerius, weeping in her chamber, sings.
I, Lady Valerius, am so, so sad. Where has the treasure gone that once made me glad?
You need a map. Raoul has a map. You need a key? You can get that too from me. Remember,
a left at the sewer, though the right might look newer, that's the secret of the way in. Now go, go, go! Up, up the rope you go! Why do you move so slow?
Let us reenact the memorable scene again between Raoul and Valerius at the bridge. I'll begin.
Oh, cruelest lady, you can take the treasure from the old keeper's shrine, but evil, evil lady, why oh why did you take everything that was mine?
The curtains went down on this guy a long time ago, but he's the best lead I have. I could pick that guy off with an arrow, but if I miss, I'll give myself away.
What do I see there?
This looks like the way in.
I can't believe how bad Wayside's got. Guy tried to rob me, broad daylight, just the other day.
Why'd you be going down to Wayside anyway? Nothing there but whores and money mongers.
Hey, my sister lives down that way.
Bet I know which sort she is.
So, did you read Cribb's latest? That gibberish is a waste of my art.
Ironic, since I always considered your art to be a waste.
And, to add injury to insult, I'm forced to wear costumes from years past.
I can't believe the Opera House is still losing money. It's all these lower-class people working in the ticket office and such. They steal whatever they can get their hands on. Valerius should fire all of them.
For once, I agree with you, Christine. Scrapping the lower class would certainly clean things up around here. But what will you do for food and shelter when they kick you out?
Taffer.
Just as you cleared. If there's any trouble, we
double the guard on Lady Valerius's rooms.
Not the ticket office. Cause if I were a thief, that's where I'd go.
But seeing as you're a guard and not a thief, you're clear on where to go if there's trouble?
If there's trouble, someone needs to guard the cloak check girl. She's all alone with no one to talk to.
When you're a captain, you can choose to guard whatever you like. Until then, let's hear it. Where do you go if there's trouble?
Yeah, to guard that watery stone nobody cares about, except than Lady Valerius.
Good. When you're done moping, I suggest you get on with your patrol.
Thought I saw something.
Too many to try to get by here.
This latest opera from Valerius and Cribs is a testament to the superiority of human intellect. Man overcomes nature. Oh, my absolute favorite theme.
I couldn't disagree with you more. This opera is more of a travesty than a testament. The only thing overcome were my poor ears by that horrendous music Cribs has written.
You're just miffed because Cribs is fond of tragic endings.
That's not it at all. Since Valerius took over, we've had to endure this Mr. Cribs and his twisted little operettas with Vines and Lycas as villains and other complete nonsense. How can you stand it?
Well, I say in with the new. That's what I say.
Possibly be any more helpful. Better get to the shadows before they see me. I'm making too much noise walking on this tile. Every key opens something, somewhere. Getting the Talisman of Air will be an interesting challenge, but I'll need it if I want to get the eye for Constantine. It's well hidden inside the city's Hammer Temple, so I'll have to do some scouting around. Problem is, the place is fully active day and night. Not even I could stay undetected for very long. Well, they say that the best place to hide a letter is on the mantelpiece. With that in mind, I'll be going in by the front door. Dressed as a Hammerite novice. That should be perfect since novices aren't allowed to speak while on the temple grounds. My contacts can get me a novice's pass to get me through the gate. Once inside, I'll be free to take my time, explore the place thoroughly, and find the talisman. As long as I don't do anything violent or get caught somewhere I shouldn't be. Because as the new arrival, I'll be the first person they'll suspect if anything goes wrong.
Present thy credentials, novice.
Open the gate!
Love is a man with the mind of a general and the heart of a king, yet also with the hands of a builder.
Builder's strength to you, novice. May the Builder guide your steps. The rules do not permit novices in the barracks, as thou should well know. Be off.
Dost thou not have some work to do, novice? Jolan hath told me that his new apprentice had released the cap upon the steam gyre and scalded himself.
Foolishness proves its own punishment, but steam burns are a harsh punishment indeed.
Jolan saith the boy shall live, but may leave the order.
Even more foolishness! Fear never shows the true path, only the downslope to corruption.
Who art thou? Good day, novice.
Because so many now build without consideration for the master builder, his mark is no longer upon the life of the city, and the taint of the trickster will always seek entrance. Time was, the sinners we take was to have no second chances. They were dispatched forthwith to explain their misdeeds to their builder.
Our strength and resolve, 'tis not what it once was.
And see what our weakness have gained us. Crime and sin reach to the very heights of the city.
Open now.
They take all this stuff way too seriously. If I don't get this thing to work, I'm not going to get very far.
What emergency threatens that they'll make us such speed?
Even on green.
Slow down, novice. The wretched man serves only the merchants in his own greed.
His grandfather cared less for his pocketed gold and more for his soul's health, but no longer.
The builder's truth it is that men without belief do soften and fail.
One down, one to go.
What art thou doing?
Thou art no novice.
Hast thought upon who is likely to succeed our master?
Surely not for many years.
Art thou blind? He is old, and the master forgers do jostle each other for precedence.
I spy not on my betters, 'tis in the builder's hands.
'Tis true, 'tis true.
Because so many shall build without consideration for the master builder.
Cease thy running at once! Thou makes mock of the builder's peace.
This will be useful. I am a wall builder. This isn't the place to be reading poetry. I am a wall builder. Let my walls endure from season to season, year to year, and age to age. Let my walls stand while families toil, armies march, and empires fall. I am a wall builder, and my walls will stand always as a shield against evil. This I pray. That will the Master Builder grant.
Alarm! An intruder!
You've got to be kidding me.
Ah! A spy!
Damn, it took too much time.
Intruder! Beware an intruder!
I shall spy thee ere long, thief.
The Builder shall guide me to thee.
Cease thy hiding, craven. Thou canst not stay in shadows forever.
I'll flatten thee.
'Twas your last warning. The villain is quick, but we shall prevail.
He'll smite this villain!
The intruder is escaping!
So long, Hammers.
Next time, mine hammer shall smash thee!
Hammer, anvil, forge and fire. Chase away the hoofed liar. Roof and doorway, block and beam. Chase the trickster from our dreams.
I'll be able to break the wards on the cathedral. It's time for me to retrieve the eye and bring it to Constantine. Last time I was here, the eye was inside, in plain sight on the main altar. I just have to grab it and leave.
But that won't necessarily be easy if the place is as haunted as it looked before. So if things get tough, there is another way out. Through the gate in the cloister, behind the cathedral. The sooner this ordeal is over with, the better. When I get paid for this job, I'm gonna retire in style. Nice view. I wonder if the dead appreciate it.
I can't tell you how pleased I am with you, Mr. Garrett. I simply can't find the words, but perhaps Victoria can help me in that regard. She has such a way with them.
Yes, we are both so very pleased.
Victoria?
Even though the eye is defective.
What? Victoria is quite right, Mr. Garrett. I don't mean to sound ungrateful, but this eye is completely blind.
It's a rock. It's what you asked for. Am I going to get paid or not?
Of course. Victoria, are you prepared to give Mr. Garrett his compensation?
Oh.
the woodsy lord and offer up your flesh eyes so that his eye of stone may see, man fool. Bids ye then the spruces to singer him an anthems, and the woodsy lord binders them fleshes to stone.
Did you think those ancient phrases were mere words, man fool? Look at me! I am the woodsy lord, the trickster of legend. If you be thirsty, flesh thing, drink of me. If you be hungry, then feed, for I am the honeymaker and the jacksberry.
He am the leaf that feeders on the fleshed ones, thems that calls themselves builders and wielded up a hammers against him.
My poor Mr. Garrett, you will not live to see the sprawling glory of it. Your sacrifice is not yet complete. My lilacs and my thistleblades must feed, and I? Stand ye then in the greens and infested maw, and speed ye of his judgments upon the weeps and writhing manfolds.
Here?
Yes.
Since you left us, you have been a stone rolling downhill. Now you must aim this remarkable momentum. It is past time for the balance to shift.
They come.
What? Wait!
The trickster will not forgive you for doing what he could not. Nor, I trust, will you forgive us.
Keepers. Looks like I better get moving, or whatever those things are, we'll waste a perfectly good rescue.
Things were supposed to go. Constantine has the eye, and my eye, and I doubt he has anything wholesome planned for it. The trickster is real after all. I don't think anyone but those crazy hammers really believed in the old gods. Those crazy hammers. You know, it wouldn't hurt to have a few dozen heavily armed fanatics on my side just about now. If I drop by their temple and explain things, maybe they'll be so distracted by the trickster's return that they'll forget to hold a grudge. And even if they don't, I know how to get out of Cragscleft Prison already. I have a bad feeling about this. Constantine got here before me. Even gonna comment. Back here.
The Master Thief. There is scant time to explain. The Trickster's foul beasts have captured our High Priest, and if we cannot retake him alive, all shall be lost. We lack thy skills of stealth and treachery, and our enemies must surely kill him should we make a bold attempt.
Come closer.
Take his key and knock and go. May the Builder guide your steps.
Cease thy hiding, Craven.
This looks like it'd make a good escape route for me and the High Priest. Interesting ride. Wonder if any of the hammers take it. Thank you. This is it. The Hammers say they've received word that Constantine's descended into his realm to perform a ritual with the Eye. The Hammers have built me a booby-trapped counterfeit Eye. If I can swap it for the real thing, it should cause him some trouble. If he doesn't notice me. I've never robbed a god before. It'd be a challenge. Just disable that portal and give the Hammers a fighting chance. There. Somebody light a match. Try that again. I've had enough of this. Thank you.
Interesting.
Unfurl, thornsy spine, tumble wall, wreath in vine, cover all, leafy's mine, call the vine, call the green, bring ye forth, world be seen. Sight. Stay inside, fear the night, call the dark, call the black, brings him forth, I call it back.
Still, you are blind.
If you hadn't noticed, I just saved the world, yourself included.
As we knew you would, as it had to be.
Now I remember why I left the Keepers.
And I remember why we let you go.
What do you want from me? Have you come to congratulate me? Welcome me back to the fold?
Very well. I will speak my piece plainly. You have accomplished that which was written, and yes, you've done it well. But there is no place for you with us any longer. Yet you will have a great need of us, and soon.
I don't think so. I'm through with heroics. And with your kind as well.
You cannot run from life as you did from us, Garrett. Life has a way of finding you, no matter how artistic a sneak you are. Listen, there is a book that you were not made aware of. I am here to tell you that it would be wise for you to read it now, if you can still read hieroglyphs.
I do try to forget, but you Keepers leave them everywhere for me.
Yes, you have more friends than you know.
Tell my friends that I don't need their secret book, or their glyph warnings, or their messengers. Tell them I'm through. Tell them it's over. Tell them Garrett is done.
I will tell them this. Nothing has changed. All is as it was written. The Trickster is dead. Beware the dawn of the Metal Age.